Hello everybody, how's it going today? A lot of people have been asking me about my build. I think it's finally time that I talk about the build that I have. So I think the ultimate goal of mine is to always share what I know, right? I think it's like being a parent, for example, right? You always want better for your kids, and you want to make sure that they don't make the same mistakes as you've made. And my ultimate goal is just to share the knowledge that I've accumulated over the years of training. And in return, I hope that it really changes a lot of lives. I hope that it betters everyone in all aspects of their life, and it inspires and motivates people for change. And I think that the biggest way for people to change anything that they want is to pretty much just take action, right? And a trading rig is very special to me. That chair that you guys are looking at is the first chair that I ever had where I made $1 million in it, right? And I'm actually donating it to my girlfriend now, and she's gonna have an office right here next to me that I'm building over the next week, and we plan to be trading together very heavily, where she'll also be taking care of the administration side. So today's video is gonna be about the hardware that I have and the importance of it, right? Whether you're a gamer or a trader or a streamer of any sort, it's important to really have good hardware because you want to feel proud of what you're doing. You want to feel accomplished, right? You want to make sure there's no stress involved in any way when it comes to lag. You want to make sure everything runs smoothly. You want to feel proud of the accomplishments that you have. You want to get some sort of get wrecked trading rig, you know what I'm saying? Or some really good system that you're going to look forward to sitting in every single day when you turn it on and you see the lights go up and you feel inspired and you feel that you've earned it. So this is why I have a crazy setup, and this, I'll tell you guys the price tag of this at the end. You may not need something this extreme, or you may need something even better. To each their own, and always cater a build to exactly what you need. Don't ever base your decision on what other people have, right? Because they may have more, or they may need more, or they may need less, right? So let's start off with the main component of this system right here, which would be the desk. This desk has been with me for about 3 years now, over four different homes. That desk and that chair, they're the first two things I've ever had where I made over $1 million, and getting emotional even talking about it, right? That's my $1 million desk. That's my fucking $1 million chair, and it's never gonna leave anywhere. It's gonna stay with me forever. But that chair is gonna be donated to my lovely girlfriend, Victoria, which you guys will see very often, okay? So this desk is from Uplift. It's a little bit loud, the music, my apologies. I don't want you guys to feel like I'm yelling over it. This is a brand called Uplift. It's a sit-stand desk. And I personally believe that it's incredibly important to have a sit-stand desk for these reasons. So this is a sit-stand desk, and I love these two components that I got with it, okay? This here, when I'm stressed out, I get on it and I rock back and forth. Motion creates emotion, right? Or it can stabilize it. So that's good. Or here I take off my feet, or my shoes, or my slippers. It massages the bottom of my feet, right? Or here it's like a ball. So when you're standing, it's important to get that type of rhythm going that can alleviate a lot of stress. So if you guys do ever invest, and ladies, in a sit-stand desk, try to get something for your feet as well, because it will alleviate a lot of stress. Standing up during the day, during work, it can just change a lot of things up, right? It can change the dynamic, it can change up the environment, or make it feel like it's changed, right? You don't want to sit down in a chair all day. Being able to stand once in a while, great. If you have a treadmill, even better. That can go underneath that once in a while. So the chair that I got, these two chairs that you see here, that one is by Modway. I don't know the exact model, but it's not that hard to find. M-O-D-W-A-Y, Modway. I just love the way it looks, right? And this chair here is a brand called Autonomous. It's very, very ergonomic. You can adjust the cushion to go back and forth. You can tilt it however you want. The armrest can go further out. It can move, it can slide back and forth. You can adjust the lumbar support, the back tension for the tilt, the neck rest, and so much more. So I find that it's a very good ergonomic chair to the point where I actually fall asleep on it. So that's the brand right there. So definitely consider getting a fairly decent ergonomic chair, in my personal opinion. All right, so moving on to the tower, which is probably what you guys are curious about most, okay? I'm actually gonna get the chair and sit down while I talk about it, because this is probably the central part of my system here. And you can also see the description for a full list of all the parts that I have. So the case that I'm using is an in-wind case. I didn't need something too fancy, just something with a transparent window. All the lighting that you see here, for example, these guys, the five, it's all Corsair stuff. And the the motherboard that I'm using is some Asus B450M motherboard, but it's got the Wi-Fi and the Bluetooth built into it, right? And that was the most important part to me, having Bluetooth and Wi-Fi built in, just to have it convenient. As for the CPU, I'm using a Ryzen 3800X. So very high-end CPU, probably overkill for trading. Can probably max out every single game out. But the point I got a really good CPU is because I didn't want to settle for something just mediocre. Something where there might be some issues with lag. For example, the 3200 series or the 3400 series. And I also did not get some sort of Intel CPU because Ryzen really outperforms it for the price right now. That's a fact. That's almost not even debatable, right? For that price point in the $500 to $600 range for a CPU, the 3800X destroys pretty much every i7 processor out, right? Or i9, whatever even. And And for the RAM, 16 gigabytes is just not enough. When you're running a lot of different trading views with 8 different screens up, you gotta make sure that you have a lot of RAM. And 16 gigs is just not enough. I was pushing it to the max before. So now I'm running anywhere between 20 to 24 gigs all the time with my trading views up. And that's just perfect, right? So 32, a little bit on the high side, but just enough to make sure that there's room in case there's margin for more program is being ran. And then for the video card, I'm running a Radeon 5700 XT. So a fairly high-end video card as well. It's got 8 gigs of VRAM in it. So if I ever wanted to transist to, say, gaming, which I probably will sometime soon, I want to build a racing simulator cockpit in this room here just to unwind stress. This computer will literally max out almost every single game in 4K. And I wanted to make sure that I had that. I'm running 512 gigabytes of an M2 solid state drive that's built into the motherboard, right? The M2 slot. 256 was just not enough to store all my photos and other things like that as well. So yeah, so very good build in my opinion. I think that it's solid. The power supplies, I went overkill with it. 700 watt, gold rated, right? I didn't want to get anything like bronze or even silver. I just wanted to go with the best because this way it guarantees that I'm not gonna have any lag. The build quality is really high. I've got high-end parts I feel very, very proud of to share with people as well. And all this smoke that you guys see here is a little humidifier. I've always had a humidifier. I want to make sure that I'm breathing healthy air, for example, right? Getting the right mixture and humidifier next to my computer if I'm going to be here for days at a time. And what you guys see here is a new tablet. This is the Microsoft Surface Pro. That I ordered a 55-inch desk here for my girlfriend. And she's also going to have a 34-inch curved Samsung widescreen as well. So this is her tablet that I got for her. This is the Microsoft Surface Pro 7. It's the, I originally got the i5 and the 256 gigs and like 8 gigabytes of RAM. Or sorry, 128 gigabytes of storage and 8 gigs of RAM, but it just wasn't enough. So I ended up upgrading to the i7 version with 16 gigabytes of RAM and also 256 gigs of storage. So this here ran for a pretty penny. But I think it's very necessary to have a very good setup, especially if it's mobile, like for mobility as well. So when we travel, where my girlfriend Victoria and I, we plan to travel a lot soon, this is gonna come with us, right? And I'll mainly be the one working for both of us. So I needed to have something extremely good, that's durable, that's very portable, good battery life, and especially powerful as well. And just some small things that I keep on my desk always, my wallet. Stays with me. Always use another phone for 2FA. Don't ever use your main phone that you use every day. Download 2FA by Google, get into airplane mode and use that only for your 2FA, and that's what this phone's for. It's not even connected to the internet, it's got no plans or anything, it's on airplane mode all the time. And 2FA for Google, it doesn't need to be connected to the internet or Wi-Fi at all. So that's really important for you to maintain your security, right? I've heard of a lot of people doing things like, oh no, I lost my phone and now I'm screwed because my 2FA was on it. That's probably the I'm glad that you learned from that mistake, put it that way. I also use this power bank right here. It's a 20,000 milliamp power bank, right? It's one of the best ones you can get on the market there by Anker. So I take that everywhere with me on the road as well. It's very, very light. It can charge up the phone that I'm using right now that I'm recording this in is actually the Samsung S21 Plus. It's got a 4,800 milliamp battery in this phone. So this is gonna actually charge it up 4 times, right? I'll go through all the peripherals before I go through my monitors and stuff as well. So this thing is really nice for the sit-stand desk here where you massage your feet on it. I'm always walking around in slippers every day, pretty comfortable. My wallet's actually, I focus on a lot of things that are of quality, right? I don't like to settle for cheap things because, I shouldn't say cheap, but more so like, I want to make sure I get things that always make me happy because I believe in quality, because it inspires me and motivates me to work harder for it, right? Do you know what I mean? I want to feel proud of everything I'm doing. So I even get things like a Secret wallet, right? These are super basic wallets, but really amazing wallets if you guys have never seen them, the way they work, right? They just pop out by pushing this down here. Ultra portable as well. It's safe so that if you walk by anybody, they can't scan it, you know? And so for the mouse, keyboard, and mouse pad, a little bit dirty, so I apologize about that. I'm using a Corsair set for the mouse and the keyboard. I wanted to make sure that they're matching. This one here is the M65 Pro. This one here is the K95 Platinum keyboard, fully RGB for both of them. As for the mouse pad, Corsair doesn't make a mouse pad, that's RGB. So I ended up getting the Razer mat. Beautiful mat here. I ended up getting kind of like a matte finish instead of a glossy one. As for the camera, I upgraded my webcam recently. I got the 4K Logitech camera. I wanted to make sure that you guys get the best view as well with me when I'm recording. So that guy ran a pretty penny compared to like the C920s. But I needed a 4K web camera with amazing quality and I'm very happy with it so far. For the microphone, I'm using a Blue Yeti microphone. And it happens to be a blue as well, right? So it's a very good microphone. Mine broke during the move, so I needed something right away. So I just went to Best Buy and picked this guy up here. And I think it'll be more than good enough. So for the monitors, okay? I used to have 2 monitors above this 49-inch. This is a Samsung 49-inch ultra-wide 32x9 monitor. And the model is the CHG90. Right, they didn't have the 4K version when I came out. And even if they did have the 4K version, I would not have bought it because I don't need 4K for trading, right? I don't need to spend another $1,000 to get it. And that's probably one of the more expensive pieces on the desk here. But you gotta be proud, right? Every time people come over to my house that have never seen my trading rig and they see this monitor, it turns heads. And then you know what I think to myself? I think to myself, one, I've earned it. Right? And 2, I've worked really hard for this setup and I feel very proud of it. And because of that, it makes me want to work even harder. Do you guys know that the first system that I had for trading was an Athlon, was an AMD Athlon X4 CPU with 4 GB of DDR2 RAM. And I was using a 5400 RPM laptop hard drive, right? That was like, I don't know, like 20 GB or something like that, running Windows 7. And this was only a few years ago because I was so poor. And then all of a sudden, you know, I had the 200 Ethereum I bought. And then I had the 200 Ethereum in my mind, which was 400 Ethereum being sold at about $350, right? Which ended up turning out to be about 140,000 American that I made in 3 months. And then that changed my life. And then I ended up upgrading my computer to something I was really, really proud of. It was the first thing I did. I upgraded my computer, I gave my parents a $50,000 check, and then it just went uphill from there. So you really need to have a good trading computer, guys, to feel proud of the work that you want to do. It's no different than being a gamer or a streamer. You got to have something that you look forward to turning on the power every day, where you know that some magic is going to happen every time you turn on this computer and you're sitting there and you have a mission. And our mission is to make money in the market. We work in the most capitalistic sector in the world. It's not like we have other things to talk about other than what this coin is doing and how much money we could make or lose from it, right? Which is kind of sad in a way, because when I talk about my job with people, it usually ends up being talking about money. But unfortunately, there's not many ways around it, right? So anyways, that monitor right there, that's the Samsung 27-inch curved, So I got everything curved just to make it look pretty, right? It's a lot better than flat. And here, you guys are gonna see Victoria with a 34-inch ultra wide as well, or all wide monitor. She's gonna be using this right here. I got her pretty crazy mouse and keyboard ready. The desk is coming in for about 2 days. So I cannot wait for her to start working with me as well there. She'll be using one of these as well, one of the 27-inch monitors here with a 34-inch wide with that tablet right there in particular. And in terms of how I set up my system here, I'm not logged into Binance right now, but this is how I set it up, okay guys? So on the left, I download an app called, see right here, you see all these tabs, right? You see all the tabs, you see the bookmark bar and shit like that. But if you download an app called, or extension called Open as pop-up, this one right here. Open as pop-up, it'll make it look like that where there's no more tabs, it minimizes everything. So this here, I keep basically the top 6 coins that I'm that I should keep track of, right? And they're general ones usually. Right now it just happens to be BTC, Ethereum, you know, XRP, kind of the bigger ones like Doge or Doge, DOT, Wi-Fi, whatever. Wi-Fi, like, I just like to keep, it's always on my list there, but I'm gonna change that right away. So this right side of the monitor is where I keep track of the top 6 coins basically, okay? And the reason why I got a vertical one now is because I wanna keep Discord always available and Twitter at the same time. So it makes a lot more sense since that's where most of my direct messages come from, Twitter and Discord, so I can reply. I used to have this guy there, you know, in the normal way, in the landscape way, 2 of them above here, but I found that it hurt my neck too much and I never really ended up looking at them at all. They were just pretty and sitting there, right? So I got rid of it. I didn't need it. And on this one here, notice my mouse and my keyboard is directly in front of it and the mic as well. And the reason for that is because usually this one here will be on 2 only, okay? It'll be on the top 2 coins that I'm trading for the day or really looking at, right? And I also have my mouse, this button right there, that one right there. It's binded to Alt and Enter. So if I press Alt and Enter, it shifts back from 2 charts to 1, right? It maximizes and minimizes, which is basically a shortcut for this button right there, right? Alt Enter, that one right there. So this will be my top 2 coins that I'm following. So the way that I'll be doing it is if I'm trading heavily, right? Let's just say that I'm trading FTM. I'm trading FTM there. I'll maximize that, okay? I'll go to probably like a low time frame, like a 1 minute one here for that one. And then on this one here, I'll go to FTM as well. But this one's probably gonna be like on a 15 second chart. So now I've got a 1 minute chart over here for FTM. And I also have, say, a 15 second chart here as well, right? So then I'll be looking at, I'll be into Binance, of course. So my trading is all done in this screen in front of me. This is the 1 minute chart that I'll be using with the 15 second chart as a trigger to enter. And here, this is just my Facebook, right? This is my Facebook where I keep in touch with my friends socially as well. So that's kind of it for my build, right? I'm also using, I think one more thing I'm missing is just a wall mount or a desk clamp there as well. And then this has a very nice cable management system, if you guys have noticed, that you don't really see any cables, do you? No joke. That's a very clean system. So the desk, I ended up getting a bunch of extras for it. It was probably one of the more expensive items on this desk as well. It's very minimal, the way it looks, but it's the features that you get with a desk that makes it really clean and the price point can really go up there. So this entire setup that you guys see right here is $11,000 Canadian. That's a fairly expensive system in my opinion, right? Each piece can go for the thousands. For example, that computer over there was over $2,500 by itself. That monitor was over $2,000, right? That tablet was $2,300. And it just goes up from there when you add up everything else as well. So anyways, thank you very much for joining me, guys, for the check. Actually, I'm not really sure what they even go for now, but that's just what I paid for it because I keep a track of everything that I've spent on this, right? Maybe the prices have changed now, but it doesn't even matter, right? I'm very proud of this setup that I have. It makes me look forward to turning on the computer every single day, and I just cannot wait to have this other office set up here. That's gonna be my reading area. Victoria and I love to read together, so we're gonna build a small little reading nook. And one last thing that I use is these Bluetooth Edifier RB2000 series speakers right there that I'll probably end up keeping there because I don't have room on my desk right now. Amazing speakers. If you guys are ever thinking of a brand to buy, maybe check out Edifiers. This video was not paid for by anybody. It's not sponsored or advertised. I'm just sharing what I have in my setup, right? Just so you guys have an idea as well. So anyways, have yourself a great day. Thank you very much for always supporting me and loving me. And thank you very much for all the longtime followers that have been around. And especially thank you for the grace period that you're giving me to allow me to move despite paying for the premium membership. Please understand that I do have a personal life as well, right? Not that much, actually. And I do need to take some time off once in a while. And I hope you guys understand that I do put in 16 hours a day, right? A lot of days. And unfortunately, life will come up sometimes. There's nothing I can do about it. But know that my heart, it lays with trading with you guys and running this Discord group. So thank you very much for this grace period that you've allowed me to have so I can actually move and settle in. So then when I come back, I'll be stronger and healthier so we can just destroy the market. So have yourselves a great day and thank you very much for watching this video. Bye now and take care.